Yeah, so in the previous episode, we covered the skills needed to progress from gold to plat in ones and twos. So if you haven't seen those, it might be worth checking them out as they have the prerequisites for this stage. I also just want to mention we have a free Rocket League course on this YouTube that you may not know about if you are new. The course is built to build a player's skills in a layered manner so that they can slowly improve with training packs, quizzes, example tutorials, and everything else you need to improve. Each new skill is about like a martial arts system. You complete the training pack or the requirement, share it in the Discord, and you get given that belt as a role. And if you do the full course, you get an e-certificate. So if you didn't know about that, go and check that out. And throughout this series, we really make a point of talking about Rocket League standards. A Rocket League standard is an example of a test protocol that combines the scores of a range of tests into a single rank index, which then attempts to provide simple, meaningful feedback to the player so they know which rank they should be. Therefore, what I am saying is if you are able to do the things I'm saying and you're still losing, then it's all on your strategy, because your mechanics are clearly already there. Okay, so let's break this down using defense, offense, and strategy. 1v1, defense. Defensively, we need to continue with our shadowing that we have utilized, and the fakes also. Now, we should be getting really solid at shadowing and faking, and as you've probably seen by doing this is enabling a lot of opportunities. But now we need to start pushing ourselves a bit. Now, don't get me wrong, we could absolutely sag off quite comfortably at plat and wait for counters. After all, that's what I did in the road to GC with no mechanics. But now we need to start thinking about building on our game. So we've got our confidence up, we need to start shadowing a little bit closer, giving less space. At least when the ball is grounded, force a connection, block the angle they are trying to take. We also need to know what to do when the opponent is struggling to control the ball. And this will happen in situations where they're struggling to control it, or they've just touched the ball and you're really close to them. Learn how to challenge from the inside position. So the standards for defense are to start shadowing in closer proximity, but only when the ball is grounded and not when they have a chance to shoot a direct shot. So you can do it if the ball isn't grounded, as long as there's not much momentum on it. And to watch and understand 100% of the challenging from the face out position video. Offense. For offense now, we need to begin implementing some systems. The main one for platinum is going to be the green belt, which is our carry system. In situations the ball is not in a position to carry, we can obviously hook into it or draw a low 50 like we did to get through gold. However, in plat, players back off and give way too much space. And for those situations, we can put the ball on top of our car and get the flicks going. Now, the first rule of flicking is to not collect the ball directly in front of the net due to the chance of getting dunked. So take it to a safe place first. That means, by the way, to the side, to your corners, to that area where they can't shoot directly. The next rule is to not try to scoop the ball when a player is rushing you, as they will dunk you. So make sure you have full vision first. If you are in a safe place and you have the opportunity to carry the ball, it is imperative. If you cannot see the opponent, you just instantly flick. It will not be a turnover if done towards the net high. It can actually put them under pressure. And whilst they are trying to make the save, you can read where the ball is going and get the boost from that position the ball is heading before the opponent. So for this, our standard needs to be get the green belt, the first green belt, 100%, which is the flicking belt off the carry. However, if you want more information on how to flick, you can check out any video from the flicking system right here on YouTube. But I would recommend just get really good at the front flick and the diagonal and the side flicks. They're pretty much all you need. Strategy. Similar strategies to before, lots of fakes and shadowing. Once you see the opponent stops biting on the fakes, then it's a perfect time to start mixing in the actual challenges. And this will keep them guessing and make it difficult to know when you're going to challenge and when you're not going to challenge. Regarding offense, take your time. If you get space, lateral dribble, hook shot, or carry. If you get a player in the middle shadow position and is therefore blocking a lateral dribble, then you can scoot the ball up onto the car with a bit of boost and go for a front flick, or you can attempt a low 50 on them. If you get a ball chaser, as soon as you get a bit of space, get the ball up and instantly flick, or if they're too close with too much momentum, just go straight to a low 50. So therefore, our standards for 1v1 platinum in defense, shadow closer and get 100% in the challenge video whilst understanding it completely. And then in offense, we need green belt one and to continue to understand all of the stuff we've previously talked about and continue to train that. Our strategy for improvement will be again to go into casual matches, playing 1v1, and every opportunity you get, flick the ball. Just flick the ball. As soon as you get the ball on your guard, just flick it. Get used to just instantly flicking the ball. 2v2, defense. Defensively, we need to continue what we did previously with rotation. Aerials can now come into play, but are extremely low percentage, so we do not need to panic too much. But again, we're looking to build. If the ball is in the air in front of the net, now we must try and get up as the first man where we can block and challenge the ball. And if we're hitting the ball, we want to try and push it to the corner to prevent instant return shots. Do not clear to the center. The standard for this is we need 100% in the sky blue belt. And I want to see the red belt as well. That's the fast aerial. Just in situations where we need to block the ball. However, don't overthink this and think we need to go for aerials all the time. Only use this when needed, which is going to be red, but we're building for the future. Offense. For offense, we now need to begin implementing some systems. The main one for Plat is actually going to be the blue belt, which is different to 1v1. Bounce dribbles and power shot is what we're going to be looking at, and this will allow us the ability to shoot at the net when you have a chance, as the players tend to play far too wide in twos, and they tend to be stacked in the same area, and this allows us to take advantage of it. It will also allow us the ability to hit shots onto the backboard, which are extremely difficult for players at this rank to handle. So the standards are to 100% the bounce dribble pack in one go, and then to 100% the various power shots whilst completely understanding them, also in one attempt. Strategy. So strategies are the same as before. Hit the ball. If you've got a follow-up, take it. If not, fake it. Fake and get behind your last man. Remember that rotation pattern. Go from the opposite side of the ball. So if the ball's going down the left wing, you can either go down the middle or down the right wing back to your net. If they cross the ball over, then you cross over to get back to the back post where you can. This way we keep outward pressure. That's all we need for now. Keep that outward pressure. When you've got a chance on the ball, most of the time you want to be jabbing into it like before, moving that ball around, making it difficult, hitting over the top, and then looking for shots when they are available. Do not rush on defense. Let the ball come to you. There will be so many spillouts. You'll have so many open nets. You just have to hit the ball on target, and it's going to be a goal. Therefore, our standards for Platinum 2v2 in defense are to get the sky blue belt 100% in one attempt, and the same with the red belt, and to completely understand the mechanics of it. And then in offense, we need the blue belt 1 and 2, that is bounce dribbles and power shots. After that, we need to continue to play 10 matches, just going in casual, and every time the ball comes to you and the middle is open, just get used to bounce dribble and power shot. And when the ball is in a dangerous spot in front of the net, get up and tap it to the side. Hopefully that helps, and hopefully the last episode helped as well. And of course, we're doing the replay analysis in between, so that should help even more. This is what we want to do. We want to get people flying up this game. Come on, guys. Do appreciate the support. Look after yourselves. Have a nice life, and peace out. Peace.